Touch down Orlando. Waiting for my co-founder to pull up. She live out here. I need to grab some more shirts. She got the crop tops on deck. You know, she do all that good shit. So I'm about to come out here and grab that from her. Take it back to the crib. Push the motherfuckers.
First of all, the last time we talked, I want to shout out my bro that's recorded for graduating from the great building coming. Shout out to all the HBCUs and for him becoming a member of Alpha Alpha. A lot of stuff has changed the last time we talked. So, man, behind the camera, I want to congrats my little bro for doing that. What has happened since the last time we talked? I graduated college myself. Started one of my own businesses. Got a little bit wiser of what I wanted to do. I became more educated in certain aspects of my life. Post graduation, man, I tell a lot of people, because the issue with our generation, or what we consider, you know, our circle, everybody want, you know, instant gratification so bad. It's like, once you graduate, they expect you to, or you expect yourself to get a job or go to grad school, like right then and there. So you don't give yourself time to really sit back and recollect and see what you want to do. And you get peer pressure by people, like, oh, you're not going to grad school, or, oh, what are you doing? Do you have a job? You're going to work there forever? And you get a lot of pressure. And I'll tell you about post-grad, man, just relax, take it a day at a time, and pace yourself. My post-grad experience, I've been graduating for a year now. It's been very interesting, slight roller coaster, but I know how to handle things. I started my own business. I'll get into that in a few, but I never felt pressured by anybody. I never felt like I had to do this. I had to live the quote unquote American dream that people say. And I did everything I wanted to do on my pace, my time, the way I wanted to do it. And I recommend everybody else do the same thing.
Co-founder, y'all.
I am Jasmine, I'm creative director and co-founder of Soul Venture.
So y'all just picked up some shirts. And I'm about to do my part, so I come out here sometimes, travel if I need some shirts, some type of product or a certain thread. I come out here, and Orlando got a bunch of that shit, so she'll get them. I'll come out and say, hey, I need to go and grab some shirts. And she do that, and then she do all the other designs, a lot of that shit. I don't listen. I'm the business side, I do the business. She do all that cool, fancy, whatever y'all see. So every design y'all see, she did. And every shirt y'all physically see, I made. So that's how it is. We here, we try to get rich. Palm trees.
I'm Soul Venture. I'm always excited to talk about it. As you can see on my shirt right here. It's an online brand, online clothes store to urban wear, really to cater a certain demographic of college kids or people that wear sneakers, matching clothes to match your sneakers. Where it came from was, I was sitting around at home February 27th, 2014, I'll never forget this day. Doing my senior paper before I graduated college, figuring out what I wanted to do after I graduated. I was sitting there writing this paper, and I'm like, you know, what am I gonna do? And it just hit me, just swear to God, it just randomly hit me. I was like, man, you can do your own clothes. Like, you can just make your own clothes. I'm like, I started fishing in my head, like, you know what? Fuck it, I'll do it. I'm thinking, like, I'm the business guy, so I don't really do the designing, so I don't know who would be able to design my clothes. And I don't want to split money so many ways. So I hit up who is now my co-founder or the creative director, Jazz Morale, graduated from Howard University, another great HBCU with a graphic design degree. I hit her up like, hey Jazz, hey, what are you doing after like college? Like, well, do you want to start up a clothing line? Would you probably, if I threw some ideas out, would you be able to design it for me? She's like, yeah, sure. I was like, that was it. So I needed a name. So later on that night, I text my brother, Kenny. I said, bro, I'm starting up an online clothing store. Shoot me 5 names, because he's really creative with that. And he shot me some names, and I was looking through them. I'm like, I really feel that, okay. And then, like, he shot me Soul Mansion, and I really just ran with that. And so when we had that, so I had the name, I had the designer, and he had me the businessman. Everything started falling in place. What else did that happen? Oh, and we do all the copyright and all that legal stuff out of the way. Now, it's the finances, it's expenses and stuff like that. I couldn't focus on it as much as I wanted to right then and there because of me having to graduate and it was crunch time with all this crazy stuff going on. But as soon as I graduated, I got straight to it. But before I graduated, I bought the machine. Every Soul Mansion shirt you've ever seen, I made myself. I have the machine at home and I press these shirts out. Shout out to my graphic imaging class in high school that taught me how to do that. So I have the machine at home and I press out all these shirts. I was pressing out shirts and, before I revealed the line, in around May, around Memorial Weekend, I told people about it, a lot of sneaker people, because once again, my brand or our brand caters to people that wear sneakers. So I told a lot of sneaker people I had this brand coming out. Be on the lookout for it. Don't tell anybody. I'll shoot y'all some shirts until it comes out. So like that was like April, May, June. I had all this going on. Mind you, I started it in February, but I was doing a lot of stuff. So there was a sneaker convention in July. In Indianapolis, and of course I'm not there, I live in Florida. I didn't want to reveal the brand yet, but it was a great opportunity for us to showcase what we had so far. And I told some friends of mine, I told Kenny, and I told another great supporter, Dynasty, to represent the brand on my behalf, and then we'll reveal it that way. So that was like on a Saturday, it was like maybe July 12th or something like that. My birthday is July 14th. So I try to use my marketing sense, if that makes any sense. I said, well, we'll reveal it then, and we will officially reveal the brand on my birthday. So I knew a lot of attention would be on me. Happy birthday, you know, I'm happy for you and all that stuff. You know, you graduated, all that good stuff. So I used all the attention that was on me to flip it around and say thank y'all for all this birthday wishes, but this is what I have to give y'all, and boom. It was a page of Soul Mansion. Everybody's like, where does this come from? And mind you, I already had sent a lot of people shirts. So on my go, everybody just posted pictures of their Soul Mansion shirts. And they didn't know where it was coming from. And they were like, what is this like? And it was like a great, great marketing scheme for me to come up with that. And we launched the website in October of 2014. And really, the rest is history. That's how Soul Venture came about. Soul Venture, an adventure of the clothes to match your souls. That's pretty much it. It's nothing too deep like people may think. So we're still growing. I have a great, great, great support system. That's one thing I must say. And I appreciate that. So that's how Soul Venture came about. Nothing too major. This is an online clothing store. If you don't want to go to the mall and grab the same shit everybody else got, just come shop with me and we'll get you right. For Soul Venture, I want to be able, my goal since I started, I want to be able to walk up to somebody that has my shirt on and ask them, man, where you get that from? It's nice. And for them to say, I can't tell you, bro. And he not know that I'm the founder of that. That is my goal. I think that moment will be where I know it's big enough for them to not even know who I am. Most of the people know the founders of Soul Mansion. But I wanted, the goal for me is to get it to where I can go places and I don't even know. I just be in a mall listening to somebody talk about it. I'm just like, I'll go to somebody and say, appreciate it. You don't even know what I'm talking about, but he got one of my shirts on. Because these are just the promo tees. I have actually a lot of design shirts coming out. But that's my goal, to get it to a point where they don't even know who I am. And they just wear it because it looks nice with this shoe. I think you should look out for our actual designs. Like all these Soul Mansion shirts are just to get the brand out. It's called brand awareness. Like, It's a marketing tool. Like, everybody know what a Chevy logo look like. Everybody know what a Polo logo look like. But I want to put this soul wrench in your face so much that it's like, okay, that's it. I know. You know what I'm saying? So we have actual designs for our shoes coming out. And that's what I think we need to look out for. Baseball jerseys, basketball shorts. Of course, when the fall, when the time come out, bring back a lot of the sweaters and do different designs. A lot more women stuff. Oh my God, I have so much stuff for you ladies. It's exciting. So within the next year or so, I want to do a lot more women stuff. Some stuff with the hats. I have some wristbands coming out just in case you don't really want to buy a shirt. You just want a wristband. I have stickers coming out. I have a lot of stuff. And actually, those soon will be included in your shirts when you order them. So in the next year or two, I want way more women stuff. I want actual designs to come out and just different pieces. And I want it to be in more